Everyone, today I'll be showing you how to make a responsive header on bubble.io. So in our demo right now, as you can see, on an iPhone X view, the header is composed of a logo and a bar icon. When you tap on the bar icon, a search bar is displayed along with the links, marketplace, login, sign up, and all of the elements down underneath it is pushed downwards. When you tap on it again, all the elements underneath are hidden, and these elements here are pushed up. So what's good about this is that we can maximize the space of the screen so that all the important elements are shown, and the user can just choose to view the other links when they need to. Meanwhile, if we go full screen, the entire header is just one line and the bar icon is gone. So how do we do this? Let's go to the tutorial. First, what you need to do is to make a reusable element. So I've already made one here. Then we need to resize this element on the desired size of your header. So I'm making mine 1080 and our height is 100. Next, you need to make a group where you want your links to be, where you want your links to be. So in this case, I want it on the right side of my header. And you want to make sure that your group's height is the same as your header height. There. Okay, then we can put the links inside of the group. So in this case, I am going to make a marketplace link, just like in my demo. Then we need to go back to the group links that we made a while ago, this one, the bigger box, and we need to edit the settings. So here under the appearance tab, this is the important feature that you want to enable. This feature where it says collapse this element's height when hidden. So you turn that on. So what it does is when this group is hidden, it essentially hides it completely, that all the elements underneath it is moved upwards, just like what I showed you in the demo a while ago. So turning this on does that. Next, what you want to do is to disable this. You don't want this element to be visible on page load. So you turn that off. Then you create a conditional where when the current page width is greater than 768, then this element is visible. So why is it 768? 768 is the standard width of an iPad. Essentially, what we just did here is that if the screen is larger than an iPad, then group links will be visible. Next, you're going to create the icon, and you want to place it on or somewhere near the left side of your header. So why do you want to put it on the left side? Because you want it to be on the very top of your screen when it's a small screen. So I'll show you what it looks like here if it's a responsive page on the responsive tab. If it's a cell phone, as you can see here, the icon is on the very top. That's what you want to happen. So going back on the builder, I'm going to change this icon to a bar right now. And then you want to do something similar where you disable this element being visible on page load. So we turn that off. And then we create a conditional when current page width is less than or equal to 768 pixels, then this element is visible. So what we just did is when the screen is an iPad or smaller, like a mobile phone, then the bar icon will be shown. Next step is you want to start a workflow based on this bar icon. So you start a workflow, and that will trigger an action that is to toggle a certain element, which in this case would be group links. So what does toggle mean? Toggle essentially just switches between hiding or showing a group element or an element whenever it's clicked. So that's what we did just now. So that is essentially the major steps in creating a responsive header. What you can do on your own is you can keep adding links under this group. And you can also create a search bar anywhere and create another group. And you can configure a search bar, your search bar group, the same way where you enable the feature that you want to collapse this element, height when hidden, and then you disable the element being visible on page load and create a conditional based on the current page width. Then you also want to add that element to the workflow that I've shown you a while ago, where whenever the bar icon is clicked, then you can just add another action here to toggle a new element like the search bar. Finally, you need to maximize the responsive feature of bubble. You need to understand what it does so that you can make your elements behave the way you want to. So for example, here there are certain features here in settings that you can play around, and you can discover that for yourself what it does, so that you can, again, like what I said, make the elements behave the way you want to based on the screen size. So you can actually drag this left and right so you can see the behavior somewhat. So in this case, my page width is now 900 pixels. That's why the bar icon has been hidden. But when I make it smaller, around 300 pixels, then my bar icon is displayed and the group links is now hidden. The last thing I want to show you here is under the group links edit window, you can actually set a collapse operation animation. So what does this mean? If you turn this on, you can actually select an animation style to make everything fancy, like how the group will be shown. You can have it slide up or down or fade in or out. So that ends my tutorial today. I hope it's helpful and you learned something. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out and I'll try to answer your questions as best as I can. Thank you so much.